and thank you for joining us on Let's Talk Tobago. This week we're coming to you from the Assembly Legislature Building in James Park, Scarborough. In our stories this week, golf is mainly a man's game, but in the case of Chief Secretary's charity golf tournament, it turned out to be a boy's game. Finance Secretary shows how the lack of economic growth in Trinidad and Tobago might be tackled. We're all going to get old, and Tobago might be the place to do so. Preparing today's children to be tomorrow's leaders. Children of Cool Kids Camp graduate. And why not try a Dashing Spritzer? Scarborough Esplanade hosts another successful drinks festival. Don't forget our special segments coming up later in the program with Lois Vincent, have your say. And you can now send us your comments to information@tha.gov.tt or visit our website at www.tha.gov.tt. You can see the bottom of your screen for more contact details. Stay with us. We'll have these and more stories after the break.
Where do you come from now? Water more than flower this morning. Cousin Effie sent and called me.
Mom, to see.
Big trouble.
She sick?
She daughter.
Mom, to see.
I can't tell you, Joshua. The dam out so big, the whole village gonna know my family private business.
She has AIDS now?
It's not AIDS, it's HIV. When you get that already?
And she's there with that boy from Lowlands? We're going to Trinidad to live? Well, all them boys in the village know you anything. You know, there are some tablets and things now that does make them live long once they take it.
They have to learn to protect themselves.
This thing that they call hormones does make them young people do it. You don't seem to understand when you're talking about these hormones, because you never be young.
There's been little economic growth in Trinidad and Tobago in the last 3 years. However, Tobago has a response to this problem. This according to Secretary Dr. Anselm London, who saw to the distribution of 22 more enterprise assistance grants to small business owners. Omodara Mills has the story.
The disbursement of grants valued at over $430,000 was given to 22 entrepreneurs to develop their businesses. Secretary of Finance Dr. Anselm London congratulated the recipients for playing their role in rebuilding Tobago's economy through the small business sector.
But you didn't sit in your corner and worry about who trying to take over Tobago. What you did or what you are doing is to hold on to what you have and build this island starting small.
In developing the small business sector, management of the enterprise unit, Shelly-Ann Batiste, cautioned the recipients to maintain a high level of honesty and humility.
If a client is coming into your business, it is their money they're coming to spend. Do not be high-bunctious and feel that you are the only supplier so that they have to spend their money by you.
Under the theme, Independence Through Entrepreneurship, business owner for over 16 years, Zelda Kernahan, explained the joy of financial independence.
I had my own business open right on the junction in Egypt. And for 16 years, I worked there. And being independent is great. Being independent, you feel that the world is yours. When you could pull out your purse and pay for whatever you want is great.
From garment manufacturing to auto repairs to the creation of beauty and skincare products, the business development unit has to date approved over 400 applicants to a maximum of $6.9 million, all in an effort to diversify and boost Tobago's economy. I am Omodara Mills for the Department of Information.
It was the first graduation ceremony for nurses who specialize in caring for the elderly. And it was also the first time a male nurse was completing the program. With the aging population expanding worldwide, Omodaro Mills has the highlights of the significant role this nurse and other healthcare professionals can play in looking after one of the most vulnerable groups in society.
Among the 19 graduates, Desmond Archer is the first male to graduate from the Geriatric Nurses Aid Training Program, facilitated by the Healthcare Professionals Services of Tobago Limited. Valedictorian Claudia Thomas marked his presence in the program as one of her memorable experiences.
Whenever classes began, Miss Smart would always inquire, "Where is Desmond? Desmond, speak up, nobody not hearing you." Let us applaud this male graduate with whom we share a bond of learning and the hope that he will be an example to other males to become a part of this field of caring.
Feature speaker Dr. Jennifer Rouse congratulated Archer and pointed to the significance of male nurses in the healthcare industry with the example of Pat Bishop's caregiver.
He did it all. She had him, she put a little annex and let him be there with his children and Conrad. I mean, Pat, he was Pat's brain, her driver, her confidant, friend, and they knew their boundaries. And that's what we're talking about, the respect and the deference. You got to know the person.
More nurses who show care, compassion, and commitment are needed for the growing aging population. This came from Dr. Denise Angus, who stated that life expectancy for Tobago's women is second in the world after Japan's.
Tobago is second in the world to life expectancy, with the average age of 80 of our women. It puts you under pressure to make sure that you maintain at least that 80-year expectancy and grow it even further.
Now 79, president of the Aqua Jogging Club Tobago is not about to slow down. Lou Williams gave his take on the nurses' training program.
The elderly have been neglected people. And it came out here today that elderly people doesn't mean that they're senile or stupid. They have a lot of wealth, a wealth of experience. And everyone needs to be treated with dignity and respect. And these young people are taught this way. And if they carry this over, then all the older people would be coming along, which may include yourself, and all of us would benefit from it.
I am Omodaro Mills for the Department of Information.
Information about the rainforest and washroom facilities are now available. As Tobago's ecotourism receives an aesthetic upgrade with the opening of the Bloody Bay Rest Stop and Interpretation Center. Previously known as the Bloody Bay Lookout, the old structure was demolished to make way for two new environmentally friendly structures. Sophie Guillaume has more from the opening of the facility.
This building was constructed here around the 1970s to accommodate visitors as a rest stop. Some of us, we call it the Bloody Bay Lookout rest stop. But it's very, very important to us. It's also the oldest forest reserve in the Western world.
Commending the residents for their patience, Area Representative Tracy Davidson-Celestine said the initiative was all about fostering the development of the community-based thrust.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say that I, as the Area Representative, and also as a member of the Tobago House of Assembly, we recognize the importance of community-based tourism, especially in this part of Tobago, the Northside District, the Northside communities. And we also recognize the very enterprising characteristics emanating from the villagers. And so I want to remind you that all our efforts are aimed at ensuring that there is support for this trust, and the trust being community-based tourism.
Commending his predecessor for getting the ball rolling, Agriculture Secretary Gary Melville said he was saddened with the time it took, but glad it was finally completed.
It took some time at first because we tried to get a design that was suitable for the area. Because what we have here today is a not only a beautiful looking building, but we have a building that presents about 2,600 square feet of accommodation for travelers, visitors, and so on to this area to serve both as a rest stop and as an interpretation center.
Agreeing that the facilities were long in coming, Chief Secretary Orville London said they delivered with class.
But the important thing about this particular initiative is that we remain steadfast to our conviction that the people of this community and this particular sector that is so important to the development of Tobago and the enhancement of the tourism sector deserves nothing but the best. And we will give you the best regardless of how much time it took, how much money it took, and how long it cost us.
The residents were encouraged to preserve the facility by their village council representative.
I hope that we all make use of it, take the best care, whosoever is responsible for it, along with the community. I hope we take much care and do our best to keep it as it is supposed to be. You're not going to get many things like these in a million years to come.
Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
Who says you need to be an adult to be a professional golfer? Well, this third form Bishop's High School student certainly proved that you don't. And guess what? He's only 14 years of age.
It was quite challenging. We had a good course, good weather, and I had a lot of fun doing it.
Saul and his teammate, Jason Wallace, walked away with prizes for Best Team in the Chief Secretary's Charity Single Barrel Golf Tournament. At 14 years old, we wondered whether Wallace may have questioned Saul's competence.
Well, he's a very strong golfer, and he actually chose me. So I was very grateful for that.
Held over a two-day period at the Mount Irvine and Plantation Golf Courses, the tournament was organized by local businessman Jeffrey Azar. As a charity tournament, this year the purse will go to young golfer Celise Granderson, who is in need of an operation to be able to walk again.
Celise, everyone here tonight is here for you. This entire weekend, this function, and everything every player is here for is to honor you this weekend. And by the grace of God and everyone here, we want to see you here walking next year. Because after speaking to the chief tonight, we don't need to raise any more money for your operation, darling. Chief, thank you.
At the end of this tournament, whether we win or lose, all of us leave with a feel-good feeling because we recognize that we have made a difference in the life of somebody. And therefore, this is why I want to make a commitment, and I think all of us must join in making a commitment that at the end of this exercise, Celise Granderson will walk again.
An emotional Stefan Granderson expressed his gratitude on behalf of his daughter Celise and family.
It's been a tumultuous last 3 years. I mean, she's had a series of surgeries, but this is the surgery that is going to put her back up on her feet, and she's come a long way.
With 47 more participants this year, the tournament saw an increase from 33 to 80 golfers. Disappointed that he didn't win in the professional category, young Jesse Jatan had to settle for the longest drive prize among the pros.
Well, actually, this is my first tournament as a professional. For the longest drive, well, I could say that for the last month or so, I've been preparing for this tournament, and it actually paid off for at least getting the longest drive. Other than that, I really planned to win the tournament, but it didn't actually work out like that.
There seemed to have been no stopping the young Simon Mary, who represented Trinidad and Tobago with distinction at the Caribbean Amateur Golf Championships, and he also came out on top in this tournament.
It's a lovely feeling to win. It's always a great feeling to win a golf tournament. This is actually my second win as a professional. So it's definitely sweet, not as sweet as the first one, but it's definitely a great feeling.
He also shared on how he felt playing in Tobago.
It's always lovely playing in Tobago, my home country. I love playing here, and I'll definitely be back. I enjoy it a lot.
We take a break.
Who that?
Leslie Kawani.
You actually have something going?
I'm trying hard, but she had to get through, boy.
In my days, boy, I would have stick in your tail until I get what I want.
What damn stupid ways you telling the innocent boy this blessed Wednesday, Joshua Walker?
Innocent?
Ma, that is not true.
I hope so, yes, boy. Because with the set of HIV going wrong, you can't afford to be going wrong with no set of girl like some of them want you to do.
Well, let me tell you, you'll be here for a short time, jollificate yourself as long as you can make it.
Jollificate yourself? That is all you could tell the boy? Calvin, let me tell you this. It have people, man and woman. They look strong and nice and healthy. You can't judge people by how they look. The only way you could know if they have something is through a blood test. I just want you to be careful.
I gotta be careful, man.
It's now time for a special segment where you get to have your say with Lois Svensson.
Regardless of race, class, or political preference, the entire country will unite on August 31st, 2012 to celebrate 50 years of independence. Tell us, what does independence mean to you?
Independence means to me that we are a free country. We no longer have to depend on Britain for our trade, and we can elect our own leaders. And we are doing this 50 years now, and it's a great success.
For the time I born, I feeling good to be in the 50th, because I make 61 years. And independence is very nice for me to be in the 50th to celebrate development. You know, jobs we've seen in Tobago opening would never happen for many years. Seeing that the youth getting something to do. And that's very good, to be independent, work for your own money.
Independent means a lot, because we are so proud of our freedom that we will make use of it, you know, build bigger houses, you know, think about the children, educational wise, you understand? We thank God for his blessing.
Being free from slavery, from dictatorship and everything, independence means that we in charge of ourselves. Independence means that we are free people so that we can make our own decisions and everything.
It's that time in our life we have to all give respect and honor to that time because we live in here. And independence is a very proud time for me. Very proud time. I just happy when I see this time in the year come around other than my birthday.
We had many achievements and things because in the past, you know, things was real dumb. Backwards and thing, but now we could see the improvement, the lifting up of the village and everything, you know. People could move to and fro, you know, easily and all this sort of thing. So I'm very happy that, you know, we are an independent country.
Well, it's good, but we could have done quite a lot more. Judging from the type of finances that would have passed through this country, we are a small country, we have plenty of money, but we could have done much more. But we are okay.
We make our own money, we could spend it as we could, and we could choose our own leaders and everything.
Some parents eagerly look forward to the July-August vacation. But for others, it can be a bit more challenging to find things to occupy their children. However, the Division of Community Development and Culture came to the rescue of these parents by hosting its third annual Cool Kids Camp.
We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy.
Singing, poetry, and signing were all part of the closing ceremony for the Cool Kids Camp 2012. Held at the Fairfield Complex over a five-week period, more than 100 children had the opportunity to participate in leadership training.
We realized that our community's children
are the future leaders of tomorrow. And by providing them with a safe, secure, nurturing environment during the school vacation period, we ensure that our leaders of tomorrow would become innovative, strong, competent, and charismatic individuals.
He made the streams so wide that flow through wood and veil. He made the rills so small that leap down hill and dale. He made each bird that sings so sweetly in the day. He made each flower that springs so bright, so fresh, so gay. And he who made all these things, he made both you and me. Oh, let us thank him then, for great and good is he.
The children were exposed to lectures from the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service, the Tobago Regional Health Authority, the Fire Service, and tours around the island and to the museum. Awards were distributed at the graduation ceremony to the most outstanding person in each age group. Even little three-year-old Olu Holder got the prize for the youngest camper, and then it was time to view the exhibition of their work.
He does love me, this I know, for the Bible tell me so.
Whether you are a casual imbibber or a drinks connoisseur, the Great Drinks Festival was the place to be. Kicking off the Great Race weekend, the Esplanade welcomed scores of patrons who were there to sample some of the unique creations from Tobago's food and beverage entrepreneurs. In addition to a mixology competition, there was also live entertainment from some of the nation's finest. Let's see what the Great Drinks Festival has to offer as Sophie Guillaume brings us this report.
Events, as long as they're consistent, we tend to get a growing crowd. If we keep lagging back, we do it this year and don't do it next year, you have trouble the year coming. Simple.
The idea came from, we're on the eve of Great Race, right? So I just thought, you know what, Great Race, great drinks, you know, and it kind of on the same compound, basically, on the Esplanade compound. So I thought, you know what, it would be just be a somewhat to turn into the Great Race. The Esplanade team, myself and the board of directors, we always thought about doing things that's different, that's not available in Tobago. So, traveled a lot, so I got the idea from, of course, North America, and I decided to bring it to Tobago.
And the event was indeed a hit, as patrons were able to sample some non-alcoholic as well as alcoholic-based drinks. From Dasheen Spritzer to various types of punches, they were all there for the tasting. Exquisite local drinks took the prize for most innovative drink.
This was specially made by my aunt, Izzy and Chance, and she participates in the Blue Food Festival, and it's called a Dasheen Spritzer, right? And it's a combination of Dasheen wine, a drink called Blue Curacao, soda water, tonic water, and Sprite.
While Monique's specialty flavors had the best presentation.
The Seamoss with the linseed, the peanut with the linseed, then we have the plain Seamoss, the peanut itself, the plain peanut. We have a Barbadine, real nice flavor. We have Seamoss flavored with vanilla and strawberry.
From what I've been experiencing since I'm here, it's been great. I like the vibes, I like the experience. I haven't tasted any alcohol yet, but I just love watching the creations of new delicacies and new drinks, which I will not be partaking of unless they make orange juice, very sweet orange juice. But since I'm here, it's been a blast.
Today, what I was more or less focusing on is encouraging people. They don't have to have an elaborate party to put a lot of money out into a party. So what I did was like a wine and cheese presentation using local fruits also, where you do smoothies. It'll be a blend of banana, pineapple, orange juice. We could use guava and mango and use orange juice as a base. And I had a variety of different crackers, variety of different cheeses, grapes, pineapple, and presented in a nice way.
I think it's good in that it's showing the innovation of the culture of food that we have in Tobago and Trinidad as a whole, because Trinidad and Tobago is one. You know, so anything that brought that showcasing anything local is positive in my eye.
Shaken, stirred, and blended, bartenders showed off their drink mixing skills in a mixology competition. Each competitor had 5 minutes to create two drinks. And despite their blender wanting to keep the drink for itself and having to start over, it was Barcode who took it with their creative presentation. And to make things even better, performances from the likes of the Lekoto folk performers, LAJ Family, Chucky and Fire Empress topped off the night.
Haven't been to a show like this for a long time. It's good. Yeah, a bit of back in time, a bit of modern. It's quite entertaining.
We want to make this into a calendar event to keep people here. I mean, the drinks, the food, the Dutch oven bread, which is in the oven right now. I hope you guys got to see the Dutch oven bread, the entertainment, and of course the lovely atmosphere here on the Esplanade compound.
Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
If it's nice, you do it twice. And in the case of the Heritage Opening Night stage presentation, you revamp it, add some of Tobago's top performers, and turn it into a 50th Independence tribute concert. As Sophie Guillaume reports, the show delighted the audience at the Dwight Yorke Stadium as it featured one spectacle after the next.
There was a lot more color and flair as the Department of Culture gave Tobagonians another look at the show that had everyone in awe. This time around, it included Extempo, Shadow, Starling, and Show in Winchester.
Mr. Fiddler, oh, hi. When you think about it, it's way back when this country produced some serious legend, men and women who left the legacy. So we have to salute them in this 50th anniversary. Not because we're small, we're going to settle for less, because we're just as good and even better than the rest. So anybody who wants to doubt we ability, just remember, little axe does cut down big tree. Drag your bow, Mr. Finland.
Tobago woman, I say you's a boss. Like Robinson, you attack with full force. But I'm no male chauvinist, please believe. Together we'll aspire and we'll achieve. Wonder. I remember Bertil Sinclair telling Dwight Yorke, Tobagonians must prepare to walk the talk. But not only walk, I say we must run like Kellyanne, Josanne, Simoyan, Lalonde.
Happy yeah. Take a bow for what you're dressing. Just like Randy Quaid, you pull me hamstring.
Ouch.
Those are the kind of lyrics I like. Like Emil Abraham, you could ride me bike. But all you want to do is sing calypso, like Axe Back Crusoe and Mighty Shadow. Bin Libby, Oscar B, Winchester showing. Happy come let we do a Johnny King.
Appreciation, place on the human mind.
Let's go!
West Indian politician, I mean you went to big institution, and how come you can't unite 7 million? When a West Indian unity, I know it's very easy. Give your homely rum to your people and tell them like me, them is one race, same race, that make the same trip on the same ship. So we must push one common intention, if for a better life in the region. For we women and we children, that must be the ambition of the Caribbean.
I was planning to forget Calypso, to come and plant peace in Tobago. But I am a great, I can't make the great. Every night I lie down in my bed, hearing a bassman in my head. I'm feeling bad, I'm feeling bad.
Sophie Guillaume, Department of Information.
That brings us to the end of another episode of Let's Talk Tobago. On behalf of the Tobago House of Assembly and the Department of Information, happy independence as we celebrate 50 years as an independent nation. As we go, we leave you with some highlights from the Carib Great Race 2012.